morning, everybody, and welcome to our service this morning, whether you join us here in church or online. For those of you joining in online, when we have children around the front today during the baptism, which I'm delighted to say is going to take place during the service, Francis, along with his rattle, is going to be baptised. When we have children at the front, we'll put the camera I'm sorry to say, you can't see them. We are delighted to see you, young people. If you get bored, I apologise in advance. I shall try and make it interesting. And the young people have already taken on jobs for me, for which I'm really grateful. The things which I am most likely to forget, I've entrusted to them. There are books and things in that corner, and sort of toys and stuff. And that goes for Francis as well. If you need to move around, move around, please be relaxed. And there's a loo at the back and on the left if anyone needs the loo. Now somebody who has got one of my helpers has got one of them. Wave at me. Oh, you have it, you. Now, I need you to keep hold of it at the moment. I'm going to show these people online what we're talking about. There is a shell. But one of my helpers is going to look after, she's looking after the most special one, because that's the one that I'm going to use to put water on Francis's head. And we use a shell because a shell is a reminder of being on a journey. Even today, there will be people walking to a great big cathedral in Spain, people on pilgrimage to Santiago de Compostela, and they will be carrying shells as a sign of being on a walk with God, on a pilgrimage. And our readings today talk about people who are on a journey. First, we hear about Elijah, who's on a journey, and actually he's on a journey running away from wicked Jezebel, who wants to get him. We hear about him in the first reading. And then we hear about Jesus, who turns to go in a particular direction on his journey of life. And today, Francis, when he is christened, sets off on a journey with Jesus, with us, his friends and his family, and with God. God, who is Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. And we're all on that journey of life with him. Our first hymn, the words are just here. Have you guys got little booklets so you can sing words? Have the young people got booklets? You just need the booklet for these hymns. Could we have a few more booklets for the young people, please, so that they don't have to share one between seven? Thank you so much. Our first hymn is a hymn of praise to God, who is Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, and a prayer that God leads us, and today particularly leads Francis on his journey of life. So guys, if you have the front with a cross on it, and then on the inside page, there are the words for this hymn. Let's stand to sing.
Thank you.
So standing with and before Almighty God, we pray together to him. Almighty God, to whom all hearts are open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hidden, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name. Through Christ our Lord. Amen.
If you'd like to kneel or sit for the invitation of confession. God so loved the world that he gave his only Son, Jesus Christ, to save us from our sins, to be our advocate in heaven, and to bring us to eternal life. Let us confess our sins in penitence and faith, firmly resolved to keep God's commandments and to live in love and peace with all. Most merciful God, Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, we confess that we have sinned in thought, word and deed. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbours as ourselves. In your mercy, forgive what we have been. Help us to amend what we are, and direct what we shall be, that we may do justly, love mercy, and walk humbly with you, our God. Amen.
Almighty God, who forgives all who truly repent, have mercy upon you, pardon and deliver you from all your sins, confirm and strengthen you in all goodness, and keep you in life eternal, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. We stand to sing God's praises. I'm going to start, and then when I point at you, you repeat what I've sung. Glory to God, glory to God, glory to the Father.
Glory to God, glory to God, glory to the Father. To God be glory forever.
Alleluia, amen.
Alleluia, amen.
Alleluia, amen.
Alleluia, amen.
Alleluia, amen.
Alleluia, amen.
Glory to God, glory to God, glory to Christ Jesus.
Glory to God. Glory to God, glory to Christ Jesus.
To God be glory forever.
To God be glory forever.
Alleluia, amen.
Alleluia, amen.
Alleluia, amen.
Alleluia, amen.
Alleluia, amen.
Alleluia, amen.
Glory to God, glory to the Spirit.
Glory to God, glory to God, glory to the Spirit.
To God be glory forever.
To God be glory forever.
Alleluia, amen.
Alleluia, amen.
Alleluia, amen.
Alleluia, amen.
Alleluia, amen.
Alleluia, amen.
Let us pray. Faithful Creator, whose mercy never fails, deepen our faithfulness to you and to your living word, Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Invite you to sit down. Guy is going to read the story, what happens next when Elijah is being chased by Jezebel and his wicked men. And Elijah has almost given up. He's almost given up. He said, I've had enough of all this. And he goes and he sits in a cave and he's almost given up. He says, God, I am exhausted. And there's a thunderclap. There's an earthquake, and God
it's not in the thunderclap or the earthquake. And then Elijah gets up and he goes and stands at the entrance to the cave. And the Bible says there is the thin sound of silence. And God speaks to Elijah and tells him what is going to happen next.
The Lord said to Elijah, "Go return on your way to the wilderness of Damascus. When you arrive, you shall anoint Hazael as king over Aram. Also you shall anoint Jehu, son of Nimish, as king over Israel. And you shall anoint Elisha, son of Shaphat of Abel, as prophet in your place. Whoever escapes from sword of Hazael, Jehu shall kill. And whoever escapes from the sword of Jehu, Elisha shall kill. Yet I will leave 7,000 in Israel, all the knees that have not bowed to Baal, and every mouth that has not kissed him." So he set out from there and found Elisha, son of Shaphat, who was ploughing. There were 12 yoke of oxen ahead of him, and he was the 12th. Elijah passed by him and threw his mantle over him. He left the oxen, ran after Elijah, and said, "Let me kiss my father and my mother, and then I will follow you." Then Elijah said to him, "Go back again, for what have I done to you?" He returned from following him, took the yoke of oxen and slaughtered them. Using the equipment from the oxen, he boiled their flesh and he gave it to the people and they ate. Then he set out and followed Elijah and became his servant. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
If you'd like to follow the words of the psalm which the choir will sing, as in your booklets, psalm number 16, and it's on page 281 in the green books. It's verses 1 to 4, 9 to 12, and then we'll stand to join in singing Glory to the Father at the end. So on page 281 in your green books.
Jesus Christ, according to Luke. And he sent messengers ahead of him. On their way, they entered a village of the Samaritans to make ready for him. But they did not receive him, because his face was set towards Jerusalem. When his disciples, James and John, saw it, they said, "Lord, do you want us to command fire to come down from heaven and consume them?" But he turned and rebuked them. Then they went on to another village. As they were going along the road, someone said to him, "I will follow you wherever you go." And Jesus said to him, "Foxes have holes, and birds of the air have nests, but the Son of Man has nowhere to lay his head." To another, Jesus said, "Follow me." But he said, "Lord, first let me go and bury my father." But Jesus said to him, "Let the dead bury their own dead. But as for you, go and proclaim the kingdom of God." Another said, "I will follow you, Lord, but let me first say farewell to those at my home." Jesus said to him, "No one who puts a hand to the plough and looks back is fit for the kingdom of God." This is the gospel of the Lord.
To our helpers here. I have, however, put in my bag a few props of my own to help us think about those readings, especially that reading from the Gospel. That was from Luke's Gospel. Now, I've got something here. Tell me what this is. Somebody tell me what this is. Go for it. It is indeed a map. This is a map, I am pleased to say, of our local area. Tell me where you live. Streatham is on this map. In a moment I'll pass it to you and you can see whether you can find it. Somebody else tell me, Francis. Now Francis can't tell me where he lives, but Emma will be able to tell me where Francis is. Where do you live, Francis? We don't need a hand. Go for it. Where was he born? Say that again.
No, you were nearly there. Bethlehem, he was.
Bethlehem, if we imagine a map, if we imagine this map, Bethlehem on our map of the Holy Land is right down here. It's in the land of Judea. Now, where did he grow up, Jesus? Where did he grow up? Begins with a N. Begins with an N. Where did John tell us where did he grow up? Nazareth. There we are! Good stuff! There, a moment of panic. He did indeed grow up in Nazareth! which was not down here on this map, but up there. Nazareth, in the land, in the area that was called Galilee. And Jesus spent a lot of time. He spent in the Luke's Gospel, in that story, moving around all this area. Moving around, teaching people, healing people, doing wonderful things, and causing a bit of controversy. And at the point where that reading starts, the Bible says Jesus made a decision. He turned. And the Bible says he set his face to go to the place you first said. What was the place you said before you said, blessed at Bethlehem, to be the correct view? Was it Jerusalem? Is that what it was? It was. I knew you were trying to say Jerusalem. And you were correct. You were just ahead of me. Jesus set his face. So he stopped going all around here in all sorts of different directions and went, I'm going there. What happened to him in Jerusalem? What happened to him? Here is a clue. It's a very big clue. What happened to him in Jerusalem? Go for it. He did. He got put on the cross. If you're feeling bored instead, in a church, a good game to play, I often find, is to count the crosses. Just look around, if at any point you feel bored, see how many crosses you can count, because there he was, in Jerusalem. He died on the cross. And there is a little clue in that Bible reading that Jesus knew that when he went, I'm going there, he knew it was going to be a hard road. Says he set his face, and again, a little bit later on, when they said, oh, should we stop off in Samaria? He said, no, because his face was set towards Jerusalem, and that would have reminded the people who first heard Luke's Gospel, which is around here in the Bible, of something else around here in the Bible, where somebody else sets their face. And it doesn't just say there, I set my face. This is someone who knows he's going to have a really hard time in the book of Isaiah. What's this one? Collected from the foot of our tower this morning. The relationship between this and the invitation to make a donation in your service booklets. What are these? What are they? Yeah, go for it, guys. What are they? They are rocks. They're a particular type. Let me give you that one. Anyone else? Girls, how about you? It's both of them. Is it? Go for it. Say it. It is flint. A really hard rock. People made arrowheads, didn't they, with flints? Yeah, Francis, you can have one as a souvenir, but perhaps I'll give it to your great-grandma just for the sake of security. There we are. It says, I have set my face like flint. Is going to stop me going to Jerusalem. And some people say to Jesus in that reading, don't they? Oh, well, I can't follow you because I need to do this first. And Jesus says, well, forget it. If you need to do that first, you're no good to me. Because I need the people to follow me who are going to set their faces like flint, like mine. We're going to follow their example and keep going, even though it's going to be hard, even though it's going to be hard. Now, when we were talking on the phone, Emma said to me, oh, do we choose the readings? Do we choose what readings we hear today? And I said, well, no, because it's during this service and those readings are already set. And then, when I read those readings, I thought, well, this is perfect. This is perfect because it's all about the way and walking in a particular direction, following Jesus' way. And there are two little details in both readings. Did you notice? Did anybody hear? When Elisha, the guy I read about, was called by Elijah, when Elijah found him, Elisha was out in the fields. He had 12 yoke of oxen, and he was doing a job. He was doing a job on the fields. Now, Francis is a dress. Francis lives in a farmhouse, and there are quite a lot of people around here who know a considerable amount about farming. What was Elisha doing? Now, Guy, you may that you are allowed to look at the paper from which you read. Does anybody know? Go for it. You might know. He was farming. He was doing a particular job that involves turning the earth, getting the ground ready. Go for it. He was ploughing. He was ploughing. He was ploughing. What kind of plough? I confess that I had to just check if I'd remembered this right. Now, these days, somebody tell me who farms today. What do your ploughs look like? Anybody? Charles, can you tell me something about the plough?
They look blue.
They look blue? How are they powered? How are they powered? Are they powered by 12 yoke of oxen?
No, they're powered by a big tractor.
They are powered by a big tractor on tracks. Thank you. Now, somebody, would anybody like to hazard? I've actually given you a clue. How was this plough that Elisha used? How is that being powered? I've already told you. 12 yoke of... Say again, you're right. Oxen. 12 yoke of oxen were pulling that plough. So, the days of power fuel that fuels the kind of tracks we have today were not with us. Now, Jesus says, when you follow me, he says, nobody who puts their hand to the plough, because there are other sorts of ploughs. And these would be the sorts of ploughs that the people listening to Jesus used, because they weren't rich people. They were not rich people with 12 yoke of oxen. They were poor people. They would have powered their ploughs by their own hand. It was a big like. You know sometimes somebody who doesn't walk very well, they have like a kind of trolley that they push. Have you ever seen that? Yeah. It's a bit like a kind of handlebars of a bicycle that they push, yeah? That's the kind of plough that they would have used. The thing in front would have turned the land. And people today, in poorer countries than ours, use those, a hand plough. Now, what would happen? Watch me. Watch the direction that I go. Here I am, I'm going to Jerusalem, and I am ploughing beautifully, in a lovely straight line to plant my turnips. Maybe my potatoes, and watch what happens now. I'm about to look back. I'm about to think about things that are not going straight ahead. I'm going to look back. What has happened to my straight line? Yes. It's gone all curvy. It has. Anyone who sets their hand to the plough and looks back, says Jesus, is not fit for the kingdom of God. Now today, Francis sets off on his journey of life with Jesus. And we are here, and we will be here for Francis to help make sure that his way is a straight way. Even if sometimes it is a difficult way, because all of us in our lives, sometimes it's a bit difficult from time to time, isn't it? And Francis is going to need all of you. And he's going to need his godparents, his mum and dad, his family and his friends to help him walk a straight way through his life. And maybe if he goes a bit off track, maybe when he's a grown up, maybe when he's still a child, the particular job of all of you here today, and all of us here today, because we might not see Francis very often here, but we can pray for him, that his way is a straight way, and that he is helped by all his friends. And I'm going to now, if you look at your booklets, it says we are on the, there's the front with that hymn that we sang, the next page, then the next page, and it says Francis, you can see his name, Francis is presented for baptism. I'm going to ask you, where it says we will, that's you answering my question about whether you will help Francis follow a straight way through his life. So, let me just move that there because we're about to get people on camera. Potentially, no. People at home hopefully can see right ahead to the cross. That's one of them. If you're counting crosses, you may not have noticed one there. So, Jesus said, let the children come to me and do not stop them. We thank God for Francis, who has come to be baptized today. Christ loves him and he welcomes him into his church. So I ask you all, will you support Francis as he begins his journey of faith? We will. Let's see if the next one will be a bit louder. Will you help him to live and grow within God's family?
We will.
That's a bit more like it. Splendid. Right, so let's have Emma and Charles, Francis, and then I need Francis's godparents, who are Christopher, Laura, Ray, and James. If I can have you up here, in a sort of semicircle so people could see you. So, particular role in supporting Francis through his journey of life. If you guys want to come up and just stand around behind the pond, we're using this pond for reasons of COVID, which and also practicality. Jesus. So nothing has to be. we ask you to bless this water, that Francis, who is to be baptized in it, may be cleansed in the water of life, and filled with your spirit, may know that he is loved as your child, safe in Christ forever. Amen. Let us affirm, together with Francis, who is being baptized, our common faith in Jesus Christ. Do you believe in God the Father, source of all being and life, the one for whom we exist? I believe and trust in him. Do you believe and trust in God the Son, who took our human nature, died for us, and rose again?
I believe and trust in him.
Do you believe and trust in God the Holy Spirit, who gives life to the people of God and makes Christ known in the world?
I believe and trust in him.
This is the faith of the Church. This is our faith. We believe and trust in one God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Now I need the shell, please, and I need the fork. Because this is the moment. Thank you very much, I have the pot. May I have the shell.
Thank you so much.
Now, Francis, this is the moment has come. Let us hope that we're not going to cry. I can't put my arms like that. And then he kind of goes across the room. Hello, this is a nice trip. You're meeting today. There we are. Hello, hello. You want to go back? There we go. Francis Edward, I baptize you in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Francis, may God, who has received you by baptism into his Church, call upon you for the riches of his grace, that together with God's pilgrim people you may daily be renewed and come to the inheritance of the saints in glory. Amen. We have a little clap.
Lord, we share in the joy of the baptism of Francis. We pray for his parents and your parents. Be with them as they guide him along life's way. May their paths, wherever they may lead, be lit by your light. Keep them all safe and fill their homes with love. Lord, in your mercy, hear us. Lord, in all circumstances, give us compassion to speak words of comfort to the troubled. Give us your kindness to bring encouragement to the weary. Give us gentleness to soothe the hearts of the vulnerable, sick and bereaved. Today we remember especially baby Rosie, Simeon Patel and his family, Lindsay Magaldorum, Margaret Bowman, James Bowman, Christopher Morris, Ray Churchard, George Ratcliffe, Jenny Lee, Jeff Kingsley Mills, and Anne Lane. And for all those loved ones who have died, we ask that you hold them all in your loving arms. We remember Ryan Sargent, Brenda Eden. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Lord, we bring before you all who continue to suffer through the war in Ukraine, those who daily live in fear, and those who have left loved ones to go to safety. We pray for the people of Afghanistan as the earthquake brings more suffering to an already desperate people. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Loving God, we thank you that with compassion and mercy you hear our prayer. And reach out to touch those for whom we pray. Let your light shine through our lives, revealing more and more of your love to the world around us. Merciful Father, accept these prayers for the sake of your Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Amen. I invite you to stand. We are the body of Christ. In one spirit, we were all baptized into one body. We meet in Christ's name and we share his peace. The peace of the Lord will be always with you.
And
with you. Let's take a sign of peace.
the power, the glory, the splendour and the majesty, for everything in heaven and on earth is yours. All things come from you, and of your own do we give you. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. Father, we give you thanks and praise through your beloved Son, Jesus Christ, your living Word, through whom you have created all things, who was sent by you in your great goodness to be our Saviour. By the power of the Holy Spirit, he took flesh. As your Son, born of the Blessed Virgin, he lived on earth and went about among us. He opened wide his arms for us on the cross. He put an end to death by dying for us and revealed the resurrection by rising to new life. So he fulfilled your will and won for you a holy people. Therefore, with angels and archangels and with all the company of heaven, we proclaim your great and glorious name, forever praising you and singing. Same night that he was betrayed, took bread and gave you thanks. He broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take, eat, this is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." In the same way, after supper, he took the cup and gave you thanks. He gave it to them, saying, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it in remembrance of me." Great is the mystery of faith. Sacrifice made once for the sins of the whole world, rejoicing in his mighty resurrection and glorious ascension and looking for his coming in glory, we celebrate this memorial of our redemption. As we offer you this, our sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving, we bring before you this bread and this cup, and we thank you for counting us worthy to stand in your presence and serve you. Send the Holy Spirit on your people, and gather into one in your kingdom all who share this one bread and one cup, so that we, in the company of St. Andrew and all the saints, may praise and glorify you forever, through Jesus Christ, our Lord, by whom, and with whom, and in whom, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honour and glory be yours, Almighty Father, for ever and ever. Amen. As our Saviour taught us, so we pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen. We break this bread to share in the body of Christ. Though we are many, we are one body, because we all share in one bread. Receive the body of our Lord Jesus Christ, which he gave for you, and his blood, which he shed for you. Eat and drink in remembrance that he died for you, and feed on him in your hearts by faith, with thanksgiving. Amen. As we come to communion, I'll invite you to come up central aisle or straight to the side, to kneel or remain standing to receive communion. Because of COVID, we're not drinking out of the same chalice. If you would like the host, the bread, dipped in the wine, please nod at me, and that will happen. If you'd rather not, please shake your head. And if you'd rather come up and receive a blessing, then please just bring your booklet, then I'll know. If you prefer to stay in your seat, do so. Let us pray. Loving Father, we thank you for feeding us at the supper of your Son. Sustain us with your Spirit, that we may serve you here on earth until our joy is complete in heaven and we share in the eternal banquet with Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. And we pray together. Almighty God, we thank you for feeding us with the body and blood of your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, we offer you our souls and bodies to be a living sacrifice. Send us out with the power of your Spirit to live and work to your praise and glory. Amen. Have a notice they want to give out, something they want to let everybody know about. Good, nor do I, apart from my notices that there will be coffee and squash at the end of the service if you want to stay. Thank you, there we are, Arthur and Ralph, thank you very much, have quite correctly drawn my attention to the fact that Francis needs to be presented in a moment with a candle. Now, you cling on to that candle. Are you Jasper? Yeah? Jasper, cling on to the candle, because we're going to need that in a minute. Arthur and Ralph, if you could present to Francis, please, his certificates to say that he has been christened, and also a little bag in which are some presents for Francis, which Soul Mothers Union, Jan, who led our prayers, leads Soul Mothers Union. There's some little things in there for you. There is a cross, and there is a shell, and there is a candle, all sorts of things. I wonder whether, would you like to have a look at that show for the time being? That is a bit more interesting. How about that one? Look, look. Look at that. Right, so do stay for coffee if you would like to. And now, let's have, Jasper, would you mind bringing me that candle? Because Charles and Emma thought, no, we're not. We'll postpone birthdays till next week. Thank you so much. Thank you. Now, Charles and Emma thought that you would be the person, because Francis is so little, he's really too little to hold a candle for himself. But they thought that you, now Jasper is Charles's godson, do you reckon you could hold it for him? Yeah. So if we could have Francis at the front, please. And Jasper is going to hold this candle for him. If you would like to stand on the step, Jasper, then he'll be able to see it better when he comes, and that might give him something to think about. Just watch you don't fall off the step. Super, there we go. And we're all going to say some words about this candle. So if you hold it next to him, that's it, so he can see. We're on the back of our service sheets. God has delivered us from the dominion of darkness and has given us a place with the saints in light. Francis, you have received the light of Christ. Walk in this light all the days of your life. Shine as a light in the world to the glory of God the Father. Now we're going to postpone birthdays till next week, but there is a song that we're going to sing to you, Francis, and you can join in when you get the hang. Happy Christening Day, happy Christening Day, happy Christening Day, happy Christening Day. Again, happy Christening Day, happy Christening Day, happy Christening Day, happy Christening Day. Thank you. And you can carry that box as well. And then at the end, you can have it. There are some balloons that you're going to be able to take home as well at the end. Let's join. Now we're going to sing a hymn. Our final hymn is one of the hymns that Emma and Charles, Francis's mum and dad, had at their wedding. And that is in the Red Books, number 394, Tell Out My Soul, the greatness of the Lord. So let's stand to sing our final hymn, 394. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face to shine on you and be gracious to you. The Lord lift up the light of his countenance upon you and give you his peace. And the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be amongst you and all whom you love, this day and forever. Amen.
Go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
In the name of Christ. Amen.